What's up? It's late and I'm tired, but I really wanted to do this. I got a very interesting video response, and I'm actually kind of honored that someone would give me this response instead of, you know, give it to some other more popular YouTube juggalo. But I got this video asking 20 questions about juggalos, and I actually only got 19 questions out of that, but I don't know, some of the questions were related or seemed to be like 2 and 3 part questions, so maybe I just didn't separate it right, but no, there's no definitive answer. And if you ask different juggalos to give a strict definition of what a juggalo is, you're probably not going to get the same answer, but you might get similar answers, as in, you know, we're just a group of people, typically, you know, the lower class, the outcasts, you know, people that don't really fit in, people that are just, you know, struggling and working hard and, you know, doing what they can to get through life. But with some of your other questions, we'll actually get more into this later. So, moving on. Well, in one respect, you would say ICP brought on the existence of juggalos, because obviously it was something that they started and that they created. But in another sense, you know, we've always existed. There's always been outcasts and lower class people and people that have been looked down on by the majority of society. So, in a sense, you can say that society itself has brought on the existence of a lower class or a subculture or people that don't quite fit into society. It's just a part of being in a capitalist world and all that. Well, ideally, juggalos should be nice, good, decent people, not prejudiced. They should treat everyone equally, treat everyone with respect, you know, just be honest, you know, good, down-to-earth people. Well, again, of course, ICP created their whole, you know, record label and following and juggalo movement, so you could say that they've created these ideas and these guidelines to live by, you know, not being prejudiced, not being racist, not being hateful, you know, not, you know, beating women and children and whatnot. But then again, those are also Christian ideals, and they're Christians, and they live by their religious morals, and they put that into their music, which, you know, transfers into us juggalos, that, you know, we're people who identify with and agree with the same morals and values, even though we come from all different religious backgrounds and even, you know, atheist juggalos, but we still have those same morals and values. So, in another sense, you could say that those morals and values that we think should apply to or be qualities of all juggalos can originate from Christian-based religions. Not sure if you're referring to just all juggalos or ICP, but again, I guess the whole moral and values and belief systems, I guess you could say, again, goes back to religion, because you know those are just typically religious morals. I like really don't know, even though I've gotten into paganism, I honestly don't know if all of the Christian values and morals existed and applied to pagans before Christianity and other Christian religions came about. So I don't know, but it's just, you know, just basic morals, you know, just basic human decency. And those ideas have been around for quite a long time. And following with that, well, of course, I think everyone should accept that. Everyone should have some kind of moral code of conduct and standards for themselves that they live by, because if they didn't, would be living in complete chaos. You know, having some basic decent values to your character should be something that everybody, you know, wants to have be a part of them, regardless if you claim Juggalo or not. It's just about being a good person and a good citizen in this world. And I would say most Juggalos do embody those basic qualities. A lot of them are just basically normal, decent people. We might not, you know, fit into mainstream society, but a lot of Juggalos are just, you know, normal, everyday people, you know, doing what they have to do to get by and survive and, you know, take care of themselves, take care of their families and whatnot. Most of us are, you know, just, you know, average good people. We're just a little bit different and not quite mainstream, so that's the only difference, really. As for the song "Was a Juggalo," well, it's tongue in cheek and it's joking around because, you know, ICP is just having fun. They like to have fun. They like to joke around. They like to make a big joke out of a lot of stuff. You know, that's just what they do. They like to have fun, joke, and kid around. You know, you can't take everything they say completely serious because they're not always completely serious. And that's something that I've actually, like, kind of learned from getting into the whole Juggalo world, is learning to kick back and have a little bit of fun, because I come from a very, very uptight family, and anyone who knows me well can attest to that. So it's just about, you know, kicking back and, you know, being goofy and having fun. So yeah. And the dictionary doesn't define Juggalo because I seriously don't think it's in any current version of an English dictionary. It might be online, but I don't quite think it's made it into an actual dictionary yet. Well, most of us claim Juggalo as being much more than being just a fan of ICP, because we really take it to heart. I don't know how to explain it really to those of you who aren't into the music. Maybe if you look over some of my past videos where I've talked about, you know, being a Juggalo and like what it means to me and what it's done for me and all of that, I might have explained it better than I can right now since I'm just tired and can't really think. But it is more than just being a fan, because to a lot of us, it's who we are. It gives us, you know, something to be proud of for a lot of people, because like a lot of us were looked down on, or we've been looked down on, you know, laughed at, picked on, made fun of, and hated. And then we find that this is, you know, something to be proud of, that, you know, being poor or being different or being weird, it's not something to feel ashamed of. It's actually something to be proud of and to be proud of yourself. So it's empowering for a lot of people. That makes it something that connects to who we really are, like deep at the core of our personalities and our being. So it's just, it goes beyond, you know, being a fan of the music. It changes your perspective on life and of yourself if you're one of those people who, like me, find it as an empowering label or something that, you know, makes you proud of who you are and proud to be different. And also for some, it's a lifestyle. It's a way of embracing their lower income lifestyle and feeling good about it and feeling like their life is okay, that is all they need, that they don't need to have what everyone else has in order to be happy. So for a lot of people, it's also about being happy with what you have in life. And yeah, it's just, you know, it's their life to them. So yeah, it does go way beyond just being a fan. Well, it depends on what you're saying we say we care about first. If you're like, if we care about what others think or if we don't care about what other people think, that might be what you're asking there. And yeah, it's like, I think most people are like that, you know, juggler or not. You know, some people constantly care what other people think of them, and some people never care. But, you know, most people, it's like we all have our good days and our bad days. So, like, some days you're gonna be more in more of a sensitive or a defensive mood, and you're gonna care more or be upset easier by someone else's words or actions towards you than you would on other days. And, you know, some other days maybe you're up in a really good mood and you're really happy and, you know, content with everything, and someone could, you know, give you the same insult on another day and you just totally won't care, you know. Maybe it's just like that kind of thing, you know. We all have our good days and bad days, you know. So some days, you know, we might be offended by something when we're a little bit down, and then, you know, the next day we're feeling better and then we don't care. Well, you know, you're always labeled no matter what you do in this world. And again, this goes back to, you know, us having a label or a title that is empowering to us. You know, everybody's labeled all the time. People are labeled by their race, gender, height, weight, if they wear glasses, what color hair they have, everything they say, everything they do. People are labeled all the time. You're this, you're that, you're too tall, you're too short, you're too fat, you're too thin, you're black, or you're white, or you're Asian, or you got red hair, you wear glasses, you got freckles, you got big teeth, you're missing teeth, you know, you're a bitch, you're a jock, you're a prep, you're this, you're that, blah, blah, blah. There's a billion labels out there. There's labels for everything. People are constantly labeling you. So why not have one for yourself that makes sense to you, makes you proud of who you are? And yeah, why not have a word for yourself that's empowering rather than to let the labels that other people slap on you make you feel like shit? It's kind of also that, you know, it's just our own word to, you know, empower us and make us feel good about ourselves and to not be bothered by all the other labels that people want to slap on us like that. And yes, I will always identify myself as a juggalo. I'm always gonna be me, you know. That's just the way I see it. I don't plan to change. I don't plan that I will ever, you know, turn into the old person who just sits and, you know, knits sweaters or some shit. You know, I'm always gonna be me. I'm always gonna be out there somewhere doing what I wanna do. So, yeah. Oh, this is a good question. And the answer is yes. I don't know if you've really been watching me or following me on YouTube at all, but yeah, I've had a huge falling out with pretty much almost all of the online juggalos. It's like when I first, you know, came into the fam, when I first got interested in, you know, ICP and the rest of psychopathic music, it took me between 7 to 12 months to actually come out and call myself a juggalo and actually seek out other juggalos online. And that's what I did. So when I finally did come out calling myself a juggalo and seeking out other juggalos, you know, I was cool with everybody. I thought that, you know, this was cool as shit. You know, I was down with everybody. You know, I wanted to be friends with everybody. I accepted everybody 100%. And then maybe about another 7, 8 to 12 months after that point, everything just like went straight to hell. Everyone turned on me. Everyone started, you know, dissing me, hating on me, trying to throw up, you know, huge smear campaigns against me, just talking all kinds of mad shit on me. And then, which only got worse, like after I met my fiance online, because everybody hated him and thought he was a fake too, and they all, so it just like got twice as bad. They thought I was a fake to begin with because I was new, and he was a fake because he didn't have a video camera at the time. So we were the fakes, and we got together and it blew up, and everybody hates us. We are officially the most hated juggalos out there. But you know what? The internet is pretty much 99.99999 to infinity percent just a bunch of bitchy ass whiny fucking haters hating on everyone and everything. The real love is out there in the real world. It's not on the internet. So just gotta take it all in stride, just keep on being me, and that's what happened. But yeah, I mean, it did make me question it a little bit, but in the end, you know, it's just all this online hate and bullshit, drama, whatever. You know, I'm over it because it doesn't exist when I go out there in the real world and go to a show, you know. You don't see that shit. All that bullshit is online. Yes, it has happened. I mean, I have heard stories of it. I don't know anyone personally, as far as I can think of. I don't know anyone personally who once claimed juggalo and then dropped the hatchet, but that's usually what happens, is that they get excited about it. They come into the fam. A bunch of other juggalos will verbally jump their case about being fake and how they're not good enough and blah blah blah, and they hear so much of that crap that they say, okay, fine, fuck it, fuck you all, I'm gone, I'm out. But you know, I probably got more hate than anybody, and I didn't drop out, so I'm still here. Being down just means that you like ICP and other psychopathic artists. You're down with them as in you like the music. You're down with the family as in you like other juggalos, you accept other juggalos, you're in agreement with the whole family idea and all that. That's what it means to be down. It's just like another word for saying you like or agree with or accept some idea, concept, group of people, and so forth. And yes, every, you know, real, true, down-to-earth juggalo does cringe and absolutely hates it when we have to hear stories of juggalos being arrested for murdering or beating the crap out of someone, or, you know, or literally going out and chopping up someone with a hatchet or beating someone down with a baseball bat, because it's just stupid shit. And there are stupid people out there that do stupid shit, and we don't like it because that gives us a bad name. That's what has everybody in an uproar, thinking that we're a gang and we're all bad people and all this crap, when it's just simply not true. There's just stupid people out there that are gonna do stupid shit, regardless of what they listen to. And yeah, but all of us real, true, honest, good, down-to-earth juggalos do hate that shit. I think that goes without saying, because everybody in the world is unique. Nope, I don't think, no matter how hard you try, even if you're like the most anal retentive conformist in the world, I don't think it's possible for anyone to be 100% exactly like someone else, let alone for a whole group of people to be 100% exactly like each other. We've all got our own personalities, our own quirks, our own other interests and tastes and whatnot. So yeah, we are all different. All people on Earth are all different. We have our own ideas, our own thoughts, our own opinions. And with all of those millions and millions of thoughts and ideas and opinions and memories and preferences, likes and dislikes combined, you're not going to get the same combination twice. So yes, we are all different. It would take a hell of a lot for me to stop considering myself a juggalo. It would basically take everyone on psychopathic, like, getting skinny, fully renouncing and denouncing all of the fat kid stuff before, and saying, you know, we're skinny now, we hate fat people, we totally denounce having ever said fat kid love or fat kid pride, we hate all you fucking fat asses, fuck you, you're not juggalos. If they ever did that, then I would be like, man, fuck that shit. But until then, I don't think it's gonna happen. So yeah, that's pretty much the only way I'd not call myself a juggalo, is if for any reason they completely turn on a large portion of us juggalos. So yeah, with that said, I hope I answered all your questions. If I missed one, I'm sorry. But yeah, peace out.
I'm a juggalo fan.